Really special, and I blew it. I shouldn't have gone anywhere near Smithy.
Notebook, spare pen.
Look, I know it's my first day, but I could look after myself. I don't need puppy walking.
Phil's told me all about it. You need eyes in the back of your head.
Oh yeah, what else has Big Brother told you?
The CID's the place to be. He loves it in there. He reckons he's got Manson out of his hand.
Does he now?
Well, we can all sleep safe in our beds tonight. Dirty Harry's on the manor.
Very funny. Got my first call out.
Yeah, well, don't mess it up.
No chance.
Keep an eye on him, will you?
Yeah, I'll look after him.
What's the call out?
Major League.
Come on, hurry up. I haven't got all day.
Some kids took a lollipop. I said we'd have a look out for it.
Have you rescued cats from trees next?
Yeah, not exactly how Phil sold it to you.
We used to play cops and robbers when we were kids. Of course, Phil always got to be the cop.
Well, hardly surprising. Why is that? He reckons he had a bigger shooter. Something's never changed.
Yeah, at least mine's working properly, though.
What?
Nothing.
Sierra Oscar 2-1 from Sierra Oscar.
Sierra Oscar from 2-1, go ahead.
Reports of a disturbance at
London County Bank.
Canby High Street.
Oh, bank job, nice one.
Yep, we're on our way. Good to hear you back, Kerry.
Yeah, thanks, Yvonne.
So then, what was that? You're not telling me about your Big Brother?
Richard Downey.
It's Richie. Thanks for getting here so quickly.
Is this your place?
Yeah, although someone else has decorated it for me.
Do you know what time this happened?
Locked up last night about 8 o'clock, so sometime after that.
Have they taken anything?
No, just left their calling card. But I think they may have got the wrong man. I'm as straight as they come.
Just drop it.
Look, if we're going to be partners, yeah, we can't keep secrets from each other. It just won't work.
Phil will kill me.
No, he won't, because he won't find out that you told me. Oh, come on, man.
This goes no further, okay?
I promise.
Phil had a little problem.
With his shooter?
Yeah, you could say that. He's firing blanks.
Are you kidding me? What, Mr. Lover-Lover?
You ever promised me you won't say anything? He'd hate it if people knew.
Yeah, what about Madison, his daughter? What's she? Immaculate conception?
She was an accident. Phil didn't think he needed to be careful.
Well.
I'm not going anywhere till I get my cash.
I've already explained, sir.
But you're not listening to me, are you?
Okay. What seems to be the problem?
Ask this dozy cow.
Excuse me, Mr.
Shorden. Henry Shorden.
All right, Mr. Shorden, there's no need to be offensive.
No need? All my money's gone, every last penny.
Well, I can assure you there's been no wrongdoing on the part of the bank.
Yeah, well, you would say that, wouldn't you?
Sorry, your name is?
Helen Briggs, customer service manager. It was me who called you.
I have 15 grand in this place. And I want to know what's happened to it.
I've been trying to explain to Mr. Shorden that there have been a series of cash withdrawals over
the
past
18 months. And I've been trying to explain it couldn't have been me. I haven't been here.
Where have you been?
Inside.
Prison?
Yeah. And I'm pretty certain you lot won't want to know. But that money's clean and so am I. I'm going straight and I want my cash.
What, you said there's been a series of cash withdrawals?
From cash machines.
I haven't even got a cash card.
What, can I have a look at his bank records?
Sorry.
It's his first day. Right, you take Mr. Shorden's details and I'll have a look at his bank records. Okay.
Can you think of anyone who might hold a grudge?
What sort of grudge?
The graffiti is fairly specific.
I know, that's why it doesn't make any sense.
Maybe it's targeted against someone who works for you.
You mean are any of my staff, Kate?
Well, are they?
We're only a small setup here. We supply organic foods to some bars and restaurants. Amanda and Paula do prep for me, but I mean, they're married with kids. Other than that, it's just me.
Any problems with customers recently?
No.
So why go after you?
You tell me.
You know that whatever you tell us will remain confidential.
Sorry?
Look, we're not here to judge, Richie. If there's anything you want to tell us, no one else has to know.
You think I'm gay?
I don't think PC Powell meant...
I've already told you. I have gay friends, some gay clients, but I'm not gay, okay?
Any CCTV?
Oh, I never thought about that. I'll get you the tape. It can be a bit temperamental, though.
Thanks. What?
It's so far in the closet, it might as well be in Narnia.
Thought 100 in the building was bad enough. How's baby bro shaping up?
Well, you know, overkeen, full of himself, chip off the old block.
Reckons he's a bit of a ladies' man too, does he?
Yeah, I don't know about that yet. But I bet you there's a couple of girls in there who wouldn't mind finding out. Or blokes, for that matter.
Well, Phil Carr's a pretty big shadow. So he's got to go something to beat that.
Yeah. Mind you, I've heard Phil's shadow's not all it's cracked up to be.
What?
Nothing, forget I spoke.
No, you can't lay that on us and then stop.
No, really, really, it's nothing.
Evil.
But this goes no further, okay?
Sold of discretion.
A little bird tells me Phil's having trouble in the trouser department.
What?
I believe the expression is firing blanks.
Right, domestic on the Cockthorn. Don't all rush.
We'll take it.
Oh, great.
Looks like Refs is over and done with.
He behaving himself?
Good as gold.
Oi. Where's your lollipop?
Very funny.
I hear you settled in well at CSU.
Look, boys, there's a lot of women out there that need a real man to speak to, right? Some of us have got it and some of us haven't.
Yeah, you can say that again.
What?
Nothing.
Hey, Phil, fancy an orange?
You look like a Jaffa man to me.
You what?
Well, nothing. I mean, really, it's nothing to be embarrassed about just because you're firing blanks, Philip.
Come on, mate. Just calm
down. Well, he swears he's not.
If he's not gay, you tell me why there's homophobic graffiti plastered all over his wall.
Well, it could be a case of mistaken identity.
Confused identity, maybe.
Look, Lance, not everyone's struggling with their sexuality or keeping some dark secret. Sometimes, and I know it's hard to accept, people are just telling the truth.
Each to their own. It's nothing to be ashamed of.
Well, maybe it's not so easy for some people.
I didn't say it was easy. I've never told my mother.
You're kidding. Why not?
Gov.
I'm busy.
I need a favour. Steve, my brother, he's not right for this, Nick. Right, he's green, he's wet behind the ears, and he's not a results copper.
He's only been here 10 minutes.
Yeah, and the silly prat has been shouting his mouth off.
Was he cramping your style or something?
Look, I need you to get him transferred out of this, Nick.
Well, first of all, we're short of PC, so that's not going to happen. Secondly, if you've got a problem because your brother is cramping your style, then you need to sort it out on your own.
Neil.
And I'd be grateful, DS Hunter, if you'd calm down, shut up, and get on with your job.
Sierra's received. Over.
I heard you were in yesterday. Sorry I didn't get to see you.
Yeah, I had to come in to sign a statement, Sergeant Ackland.
You okay?
Fine, thanks.
Listen, I want
to... Cameron, I don't want to have this conversation, right? I just want to get on with the job. Any gossip?
What?
Is anything juicy going on I should know about?
No.
Should liven up now I'm back. Always good for a laugh, me.
Oh, what are you doing here?
I could ask you the same question. Nice to see you again, Mr. Shorden.
Your neighbour called, worried about the noises come from here.
Yeah? Well, we're fine, so there's no need to stay.
Is this your house?
Yeah.
What's your name?
Liz Squires. Look, I'm all right. Honest.
I haven't laid a finger on her, so you can sling your hook. No, better still, arrest her.
Mr. Shorden, I think it might be an idea if you called off a bit.
I'm not going anywhere. Not till I get my cash.
I haven't touched your money.
It had to be you. No one else knew
about
it.
I swear.
Door's wide open. Anyone could walk in. Someone want to tell me what's going on?
Sorry, didn't catch your name.
That's because I didn't give it to you.
Your name?
Pete Morgan. Do you want me to spell it?
Right, do you want to step outside, Mr. Shorten, so I can have a word?
About what?
You wanted us to investigate the theft of your money.
No. No, it's not a problem.
Well, 15 grand's not a problem.
I must have made a mistake.
Right.
I can't believe we're going back to the Nick. We should be arresting Liz.
On what grounds?
Suspicion of theft.
Look, Henry Shorten and Liz Squires don't want us involved, and until they do, we can't do a thing.
Oh, come on, there's something up there. You know as well as I do.
Look, Steve, I know what I saw. Yeah? Henry's obviously bothered by Pete Morgan, whoever he is, the way he shut up when Pete walked in.
So we do nothing about him?
No, we play the long game. We go back to the Nick, we do a criminal search on Pete Morgan, find out more about him, yeah? Gather some intelligence. Use our judgment.
But in the meantime, Morgan lets off Henry over 15 grand.
We don't know that.
It's obvious.
Well, nothing's obvious in this job. You'll learn.
I shouldn't even be here. I tried telling the DI that, and he was having none of it. What's up?
As if there weren't enough racist idiots out there, looks like we've got them in here too.
Where'd this come from?
Internal mail.
One of our lot. Look, this could be someone from our Nick. You get forensics to look at that. Then go and see a Caro. If anyone's going to understand, he will.
You would have thought so. I don't think I'm his favourite copper right now.
Time is 10:03 last night, and there's three of them. How many were involved in the Canley Field attack?
Just the one. It was a vague description. He was wearing a white coat.
Could be. Not clear enough for a proper ID, though. Although he is wearing a white coat.
Hang on. He looks familiar.
Linked him before?
Maybe. It's a bit too blurred. I'm sure I know from somewhere. Come on.
Where are we going?
We'll see if we can find out who this idiot is.
Oi. Come with me.
Do this.
Come over and get in there. Tell me why. What is it? Cozying up to your new mates in uniform? Well, you could have chosen something other than my fertility problem to broadcast on your first day.
Just sort of slipped out, I'm sorry.
You're sorry? Well, is that the best you can do? You haven't changed, have you? You're still causing trouble. And you're still hanging around me like the snotty-nosed kid that you were.
Phil, just chill out.
I wrote a special fishing!
Go on then. Go on, do it. Mum was right by you. You're just like Dad, using your fists. So go on then.
You keep your mouth shut. Do you understand me?
Have you received anything like this before?
No. I'd have reported it if I had.
Yes. Of course. Any ideas?
Which one of our colleagues is a racist? No. But it's a comforting thought, isn't it?
Look, I can understand your anger and frustration.
Can you?
Yes. But let's not jump to any conclusions.
So, what are you going to do?
Find out who sent this letter. If it's a serving police officer, I'll see that they're excluded from the force. I'll have D.I. Manson conduct an inquiry. You have my word. We'll get to the bottom of this. Was there anything else?
No, sir.
Oh, and thank you for coming to me about this.
What do you want?
Say sorry. Look, what I said about that, it was out of order.
What are you doing in here?
I'm trying to do some work.
I thought you were in CID.
Yes, well, I've been seconded here for a while, all right, to add a fresh perspective. Now, I'll be back in CID as soon as they come up against a quality villain they can't handle.
Someone like Pete Morgan?
Morgan?
Do you know him?
Yeah, Teflon man. Can't get anything to stick. We've had him in court before, but he walks every time. What now?
I've got some information on him.
Well, you told CID?
I thought I was.
So what are you planning to do now? What, one day on the job and you think you're RoboCop?
Well, wonder where I get that from.
Well, so Morgan's hardly big time, but he is a loose cannon. So if you're thinking about being a hero, you forget it. I mean it, Steve. You stay well clear. You got any information, you pass it on to the DI, all right? Muppet.
This is a long shot, Sheila. That tape won't stand up in court.
I'm sure it's Bobby Abinson. Tony lifted him for threatening behaviour last year outside the Pike's Head pub. I booked him in. I never forget a face. Come on.
Even when it's ugly, sir.
Cruel but fair.
Bobby Abinson.
What's it to you?
Need to ask you a few questions, starting with where you were at 9 o'clock last night.
You want to tell me what this is about?
You answer our question, we'll think about answering yours.
I'd have to talk to you.
Your choice.
Is that my girlfriend's house, Kelly?
Could she verify that?
Nah, she was working. I was with her mate. We've been doing up her flat, you see. He's an electrician.
It's handy. Where does Kelly live?
Just round the corner.
Mind leading the way? Is your girlfriend in?
Nah, she's at work.
What does she do?
She's a nurse.
So, where's this imaginary friend of yours, then?
Mum.
So what do you want to talk to me about?
Pete Morgan.
Go on.
Boy, you lot have been after him for years, haven't you?
And?
I can give him to you on a plate.
Right.
Look, mate, I'll level with you, okay? It's your first day, right? And I can help you. I mean, it would look pretty good, wouldn't it? Nicking someone like Pete Morgan on your first day. You'd be doing me a favour too.
This is the bit I'm struggling with.
Pete Morgan's taken the only thing in the world that really mattered to me.
Your money?
No, not the money. Liz.
Where were you at 9 o'clock last night? Connor, look at me.
I was here, doing some rewiring for Kelly.
Was there anyone else here? Connor, look me in the eye and answer the question.
Bobby was here.
We have CCTV footage that possibly places Bobby elsewhere last night. How do you explain that?
I can't.
I want to trust you.
You can. What's going on? Am I in trouble?
Can you think of any reason why you might be?
No.
Well, then you're okay, aren't you? As long as you're telling the truth.
Has Bobby done something?
We think Bobby may be involved in homophobic crimes. I'm just disappointed in your poor taste in friends.
If he did do it, Mum, do you really think I'll be hanging around with him if he was like that?
I hope not, Connor. I really do.
Pete's into knocked off goods, bits and pieces of everything. But he's hit the big time recently with the booze that he's been selling. Bootleg stuff, vodka mainly.
That's what they've been using your money for?
Yeah, he must have talked Liz into it.
How do you know all this?
Look, just because I'm going straight doesn't mean all my mates are. Word gets around and I've been asking a few questions. They ship it in from Holland, then they sell it around the pubs and the clubs. Now they've got a warehouse, and there's a lorry load due this afternoon.
Is this some sort of wind-up?
Look, I know what you're thinking. Ex-con, why should I trust him? But what have you got to lose, eh?
My job.
Just check out the warehouse. There's nothing there, fine. But if you nick Pete Morgan, well, I'm happy because he's off the scene, and you, well, you'd be a hero, wouldn't you?
So where's this warehouse?
fine. Thanks.
I was hoping we could still be friends.
From what I hear, friend's the one thing you're not sure of.
Sorry?
Honey Harmon?
What about her?
You tell me. You slept with her.
I wanted to tell you.
Don't pretend you were protecting my feelings.
Nothing happened between Honey and me, not really. Those two kids died and I was a mess. And she was there for me. She knew exactly what I was going through because she was going through it too. Yeah, okay, we kissed. And that's all. But it just happened.
So, you just needed a shoulder to cry on. Well, there's a pattern developing here, isn't there, Cameron? Because I seem to remember you came to me for comfort when Sheila's daughter died. That's how we got together, do you remember? But, do you know what? I'm happy for you. You've obviously got over me. Just like I've got over you.
Kerry. Wait. Hey, I still care for you. Even after what happened to you with Gabriel.
Are you saying you believe me now?
I don't know what I'm saying.
Oh, well, until you do, I don't think we've got anything to say to each other. And if you tell anyone at all, what Gabriel did to me, I swear I'll kill you. Do you hear me?
Loud and clear.
It's my business to deal with my way in my own time. Nobody, especially not Honey Harmon, needs to know about it.
DC Badger.
Sir.
I've spoken to the I-Manson about the hate mail, and I've asked him to start an internal investigation. I presume he'll be speaking with you in due course.
Sir?
There is a matter I should have raised when we last spoke. I've received similar racist mail.
What?
I realize I should have said something earlier. In fact, I should have reported it before now.
I'm sorry, you didn't report it?
Come on. Black man in my position, it goes with the territory. It's not the first time I've received racist abuse from some Neanderthal.
From someone in her own nick?
No. This is the first time it's been internal. Which is why I should have reported it. I realize if I had, we might have got to the bottom of this and I could have saved you a very unpleasant experience.
Yeah, well, sticks and stones and all that.
Anyway. I'd rather we didn't publicise this, so let's just let D.I. Manson get on with his investigation and then we'll see. Okay?
Sir. Stand up and be counted, are you not?
Sorry?
I just received racist hate mail.
What?
In the internal post, yeah. Only thing is, so did the super. But you won't do anything about it.
Why not?
No, it's obvious, isn't it? He can't face the fact that one of his officers is racist.
Is there something you want to tell me?
No, why?
Well, you said earlier you were at the chemist.
I was.
Don't lie, you weren't. I checked. What are you up to?
I went to meet Henry Shorden.
You did what?
He had some information on Pete Morgan.
You don't get this, do you? I'm puppy walking you. It's your first day. You don't do anything without telling me. That's how it works.
I'm telling you, it's Morgan who ripped Shorden off. He's using his money to buy bootleg vodka. They're bringing a shipment in this afternoon.
All right, slow down, Steve. All right, any information you have, you take it to CID.
I promise Shorden.
The ex-con?
He's kosher. Henry just wants a chance to get Liz back. He wants Morgan behind bars like we do. That's why I promised him we'd check the warehouse out.
You did what?
Vaughn, I need your help. Look, we check the warehouse out. If there's anything dodgy, we take the CID. I promise.
Look, quit while you're ahead, Steve. Okay?
Look, I'll go on my own if I have to. I mean it.
Yeah, I know you do. You got an address?
We're arresting a suspect, so I'd like to get a statement off you.
Sure, no problem.
No, cheers. There could be a link between yours and another homophobic attack, so I'd like to ask you a few more questions.
Look, how many times have I got to tell you I'm
not gay? Yes, I know, but whoever did over your place seems to think you are. You said you had gay friends.
My best mate, he runs a pub. We supply his kitchen from time to time.
What pub?
The Pike's Head. What is it?
There was one other attack. The victim was gay and he was seriously assaulted.
Yeah?
Well, there could be a link. The suspect was previously arrested at the Pike's Head.
Well, that's why I was targeted, because I was drinking in my mate's pub.
Maybe.
It was PC Kent that made the connection.
Plymouth, Portsmouth, what connection?
Well, in both cases, the attacks were swift. The rapist seemed to come from nowhere. He had a knife, which he held in his left hand, to the throat of the Plymouth victim. There were minor cuts made to the body of the Portsmouth victim. Vocally, he was aggressive. And the MOs together are similar to the Candley serial rapes.
What about DNA?
No traces in the Portsmouth case. But traces of animal DNA were found on the clothing in the Plymouth case. Rabbit, to be precise.
Rabbit DNA?
Yeah.
And how does that bring us closer to the attacks here?
I think we need to get Dr. Hugh Wallace back in here to look at these cases. I am sure we can make a connection.
Dr. Wallace, for all his expertise in geographical profiling, hasn't got us any results so far.
Well, it takes time to build a full picture.
And that's one thing we don't have. The super's right, the press are all over this and people are beginning to panic. We have a serial rapist who could strike again at any minute. So forget Hugh Wallace. You're the detective, put the pieces together yourself.
Gov.
What are you doing?
Going to have a look.
Just hold on.
This Morgan has been taking the mick, making a laughing stock out of us. It's about time we did something about it.
Look, the city is crawling with Pete Morgans. Drug dealers, armed robbers. We all know who they are, but sometimes we can't do anything about it.
Someone has done something wrong, and I want them to pay the price. That's why I'm doing this job.
Well, try not to take it too personally.
I do take it personally. My best mate was shot. I was there, and I watched him die. It's pretty simple to me, right and wrong.
You're a probationer. You don't do anything unless I say.
Just give me 5 minutes to see what's going on. I won't do anything stupid, I promise.
It's bad news, isn't it?
I think we've definitely got our man. We found red paint on Bobby Abson's jacket. Could be a match to the red paint that was on Richie's van. We're going to send it away for analysis. Bobby was also wearing a white jacket, just like the attacker. The assault was clearly motivated by homophobia.
I thought you said the MO was too dissimilar to link it to the other case.
That was before I found out that Richie's best mate is the landlord of the Pike's Head. Richie drinks there. Bobby was arrested outside the Pike's Head for threatening behaviour.
Stupid boy.
Look, Sheila, I hate to say this, but if Bobby is involved, there's a chance.
I know. Connor lied to us, but why would he cover for him? Bobby must have made him.
Unless Connor's involved too.
I didn't bring my kids up to be raging homophobes. Connor wouldn't do this unless his hand was being forced. He needs to just admit he was lying and dump his so-called friends.
No, I've been waiting here, as I said, 20 minutes, all right? I need to know where he is. I've got to move this gear. Just tell him to get a move on, all right?
PC Steve Hunter. Care to tell me what's in the van?
Nothing to do with you. What, you got a warrant? Drop it.
Pete!
Shut up, Liz. I said drop it.
Steve? Steve? Sierra Oscar from 298, backup required at a warehouse on Water Street, number 15.
Who is it?
It's Kerry. Can I come up? We need to talk.
We've got the place surrounded.
And they sent you in here on your Todd, armed with a truncheon? Get in there!
What are you going to do with him?
Shut up! Put him in a van and deal with him later.
You're out of your depth, Morgan. You're making a big mistake.
Pete!
Shut up, Liz! No, you're the one who's made the mistake.
You don't need a gun.
Maybe I've gone up a league.
If something happens to me, they'll come after you.
They've got to find me first.
Shouldn't be too hard. How do you think I knew where you were? Someone grossed you up.
Jordan! I'll kill him!
Are you going to shoot him as well as me?
Pete, for God's sake...
Shut up, please!
Over a van load of booze. Call that moving up, Elite.
Both of you, shut up! Come on, let's get out of here.
No!
You what?
No!
Pete, make it easy on yourself. Give me the gun.
Well, well. If it isn't the rape victim. What are you after? A repeat performance?
Stay back! He's got a gun! Pete, do the right thing.
I want you to admit that you raped me.
Really?
You know I can't make an official allegation, not after you conned me into accusing Smithy of the same thing. You knew when you raped me that no one would believe me.
I just sensed an opportunity, that's all. I saw you kissing Smithy at the pub. When I realised you slept with him, well, that offered me a way in. And it was so, so easy, Kerry. Anything to stop you feeling guilty about doing the dirty on camera? All I had to do was mention the words date and rape and you were off. All I had to do was sit back and watch.
Hardly. You spread the news around the relief. So when did you decide that you wanted to rape me?
That wasn't the plan. I was prepared to play it by the book, but you used me.
I'm sorry.
Whose shoulder did you cry on when you did the dirty on Cameron? Me. Who did you come running to when that sad little life of yours was falling to pieces? Me.
If my life's falling to pieces, it's your fault.
Oh, yeah? Did I force you to sleep with Nick Klein and Smithy? Did I suggest you marry a queer? Did I pressurise you into having an abortion? Your life was a disaster before I ever walked in the Sunhill police station. You treated me badly, Kerry. Made me think we had a chance.
A chance of what?
Love. Life. Happiness.
Mum. You're wasting your time.
No, Connor. You're the one wasting time. Police time.
I was with Bobby last night at 9 o'clock. Why don't you believe me?
Because I know you're lying. I know you're covering for him. Connor, don't be so stupid. Do you know how close you are to having to go to court? You're one step away from prison.
It's the truth.
This isn't the way I brought you up. To lie.
No. You set a great example, didn't you? You cheated on your husband. You had a bastard child. You destroyed an entire family. But none of that matters now. You're a model parent. Don't lecture me, you hypocrite. Anything that I've done is nothing compared to the damage you've caused.
We think Bobby's beating the living daylights out of gay men. You think that's nothing? What are you going to do if this goes to court, Connor? Lie on oath. That's perjury. You get found guilty of that, you could be facing up to 7 years.
Well... let's just hope it doesn't come to that, then.
All right. I raped you. Now get out.
I want to know why. Why did you rape me? I want answers. I need answers.
Do you want me to do it again? Is that it?
No.
Do you?
I said no.
Just go. Oh, and you can leave the dictaphone. Or is it a wire? Nah. You wouldn't be able to organise a wire. So it'll be a dictaphone. You get a record of me on your phone. Whatever it is, hand it over. So whose benefit was this for, eh? Cameron? He didn't believe I raped you for 1 second. Do you really want him back after that sort of betrayal? Or were you planning to play this to Inspector Gold?
I don't know.
Well, it doesn't matter, does it? Unless this is a bluff and you've got another device. I could always frisk you.
I don't know.
Chuck me your phone. Close the door on your way out.
There was a rape in Lanarkshire in 1989. The attacker had a London accent. Now, the statement at the time was poor, but there are similarities with the Canley rapes.
You want to go to Scotland?
I think this woman could be our rapist's first attack. I want to re-interview her.
Well, I haven't got the resources to fund the trip. And what about this strike the hood phrase that was used in the rape cases here?
The victim didn't report it. But that could indicate that his confidence is growing, his MO evolving. Just 2 days, Gov, that's all I'm asking.
We're in the middle of a major investigation. You can't...
This could be the breakthrough we need. I need to catch this man, whatever it takes.
Okay, 2 days, that's your lot.
Thank you, Gov.
PC Hunter. Sir, I believe congratulations are in order.
I got lucky.
Well, that's very modest of you. Because I'm pretty certain there's more to it than that.
Sir?
Pete Morgan's in custody. He reckons it was Shorten who grassed him up to you. That's the last time you ever do the bidding of someone like Shorten, do I make myself clear? Sir, you're here to do a job, do it properly, otherwise I might start agreeing with your brother.
Sorry, sir.
Oh, Phil wanted you transferred, but I thought it was worth taking a chance on you. Prove me right.
You still here? You see, if I was a rape victim, I wouldn't be hanging about in my attacker's flat. Suggest you enjoyed it. Which means you weren't raped.
I haven't done anything. Why single me out?
Eeny, meeny, miny. Mo.
You've destroyed my relationship with Cameron. It was cruel, it was vicious. I'm not a bad person. I'm a bit all over the place sometimes, emotionally. Maybe I'm misguided, wayward, but I'm not evil. I never actually set out to hurt anyone. I never set out to hurt you. So why put me through all this? Why take my life and smash it into pieces? Why me? If you've got a shred of humanity in you, you'll tell me. Please.
I'm sorry.
For raping me or for crying in front of me?
Both.
So,
What's gone wrong?
Well, Carl came clean about getting the hate mail. It's out in the open now.
Well, he only reported it when you confronted him. What's that say about him? Where's his passion, his pride? If that were me, I'd be tearing the place down trying to find out who sent the letter.
Yeah, me too.
He's out for himself, Rob, nobody else. Us sending those letters was just the beginning.
Okay, so what are we going to do now?
We expose him for the hypocrite that he is. We're going to bring Adam Akaro down. You and me.
I get so angry. It's like my whole body's on fire. Sometimes I feel I could kill someone. Not just in the heat of the moment. It could be weeks, months even. Then it's like someone flicked a switch. Just now when you said, do I have any shred of humanity in me, I...
Is there?
I don't know. If I did, would you help me find it, Kerry?
You rape me.
I know. And I'm truly sorry. Suddenly I'm sorry. Why am I feeling this now? Why have I put you through so much pain?
You've got to face up to the consequences of what you've done.
Will you help me, Kerry? Please? You women, you're amazing. So bloody gullible!
Don't do this.
I'm not sorry. I'm not sorry at all. Everything I've done to you, you deserved.
So you get your kicks abusing women, abusing their trust.
Oh, yes. You see, you're not the first woman a son he'll have a little bit of fun with.
Oh, so you've raped someone else at the...
No! Not right, no. Something much more creative than that. Bolder. More daring.
Looks like you're gonna have to keep your eye on Steve Hunter.
Yeah, just like his brother. What a day. Oh, go on, step on it. Let's get back to the Nick. There's a drink with my name on it.
You're saying?
Oh, can't we leave it?
Ah, come on. Call it in. Let's show him there's life in the old dog shit.
Speak for yourself. Sierra Oscar from Sierra One.
That was a grand plan. I really took her to pieces. But you... You were so easy, Kerry. Taking candy from a baby, but her... That took weeks. Months. Bit by bit, easy does it. But the results... It was worth every minute just to see her face when she realised what was...
Yeah? So how come you're not laughing now?
Come on, boys, give it up. This is a derelict.
That'd be interesting.
There, they're bailing.
No, I'll chase them. You try and cut them off at Raven Street.
What you gonna do?
The Met. They're always banging on about restorative justice. Victims coming face to face with their attackers, getting some sort of redress.
Go on then. You can't, can you? You see, you want justice. But you can't do to me what I did to you. Men can't be raped. Not by a woman, anyway. Face it, love. I've won again. I told you not to cross me.
What's it gonna take for you to leave me alone?
The only way this will end is with one of us dead.
That sounds good to me.
That or our wedding day.
I'll tell you something. If you want a fight, I'll give you a fight. I promise you I'll see you behind bars or I'll see you dead. See, the thing is, Gabriel, I don't care about anything anymore. All I care about is finding a way to destroy you. So... bring it on, rapist. I'll be waiting.
Doing a bit of undercover work for us. My brother's in London.
Please, I just want to talk to you.
You've had your say. Now it's my turn.
Looks like my brother's just moved up a league.